My name is George William Okoit. I am the chairperson of the Teso Link Welfare Association, an association that came to life in the month of February after we lost a friend called Ada. We buried him and we felt that as young people, there was a need for us to get organized. And Ada's death became a rallying point and a challenging moment for every young person. We felt so vulnerable, we felt so alone, and we thought that the unity and the love and the commitment that the youth by then gave during his medication and subsequently his burial was so promising that out of it, we decided to put young people together into a formal organization and platform like the one we are launching today. This is because we wanted to enhance and harness actually the power of unity and the little love that we all each held together into ourselves. And today is a very special day to the entire membership of TELWA, to the entire region of Teso, to the entire country of Uganda, and possibly to the continent of Africa. We want to use TELWA to be a vehicle to reinvent and revitalize the spirit of love, the ubuntu spirit in young people. Is what we are trying to achieve at a community where young people trust one another, where young people support one another, regardless of your political affiliation, regardless of your religious belonging, regardless of your background. We want to have a community that accepts everybody the way they are. So we are not limited to just burials or anything. We are envisioning a community in TELWA where we are going to do an investment club where people save in money and do something that at the end of the day benefits every member within TELWA. We want to create a vehicle that we are going to ride on to build on charity, you know, where we are able to support vulnerable people through our contributions every day and monthly, and whatever donation we may get, we want to be accountable to our community. We want to be young people of reason and value. That's what we are trying to build on, to re-establish and re-engineer a new narrative of how young people are viewed at. Today we are here with different people. Teso Vibes is here supporting us, the scouts are here supporting us, the radio stations are here supporting us, and everybody who is in these organizations, these are young people. So we want to see how we can bring in the energy in Teso Vibes, the radio presenters, the TELWA members, and everything to see to it that the glory of Teso is given back to us, and then we have reason to really work hard everything, because we are the hope for tomorrow, and we must be part and parcel of the process to create the hope for those who will come after us, because I'm very sure we will not be here forever, but we should be able to set a foundation that is going to drive Teso into a greater milestone that is going to bring glory and honor into our young people.
Okay, so what are the requirements for one to actually be a member in TELWA, and now what number are you looking at as a chairperson? What number of members are you looking at to join the association?
Our requirements for membership are very simple, because we understand the economic stand of Teso and the country today. Our membership is as simple as 10,000 shillings. 10,000 non-refundable 10,000 shillings is what we pay as membership. But we have a setting that is called monthly subscription. Monthly subscription, every member is required to remit 10,000 shillings. That 10,000 shillings, the treasury keeps that money for 3 months. In 3 months, we sit as an association and agree what can we do with this money. We want to have our own chairs, we want to have our own tents, we want to have our own cameras, we want to have our own everything, even vehicles, so that if anybody has an event, maybe a wedding, maybe a burial, maybe you even want to hire it, the association is able to get revenue from there, and that revenue is what we think is going to be shared as dividends to members for the investment they have put in buying the chairs, buying the tents, buying the bus, buying anything that we are going to be able to achieve. I thank God that right now the banks are able to open up and say we can work together to grow together. So our task as an association is to make sure that we come up with ideas that if the banking sector is able to come and support, they support a revenue mobilization activity that can add value to the revenue of the association and eventually add value to the revenue of the members, because out of the profit that we are going to generate from these activities, we would want to use this money to build the capacity of every member. You who is doing business, what can we give you out of the interest that we have accrued from the hire of chairs, hire of tents, hire of the bars? We have a lot of things that we have put in place. Now, we look at having the spirit of TELWA in every member. So our membership is unlimited, even if we have a million people. As long as we're able to manage and know and be able to execute the core reason as to why TELWA was established, then our numbers are not limited. Because if we can build this in people, then we don't even need only TELWA. We need just a community that is there to support one another. If we achieve that, then TELWA has achieved its purpose. Ours is to unite the people, to be able to share what they have with those who don't have, so that at the end of the day, nobody is lacking, surely. That is what we look at as TELWA.
What is the perception of people outside there?
In the last few months, honestly, we have been trying to fight negative sentiments. People believe, because me as a poet, everybody knows I'm a politician. But I'm also a human being. Before I entered politics, I saw blight. So I thought that by becoming a politician, I'll be able to give my ideas to the powers that be. But unfortunately, whatever I thought I could do as a politician in 5 years, I wasn't able to achieve anything. Yes, I was able to inspire young people, but I wasn't able to address even a single thing. I every day I look at myself, I'm like, how am I honorable? I've not done anything honorable. So I am still sealed up to see to it that, besides my political attachment, there is human life in me that is telling me that there is something that we can do together. So I don't want to say that people who think we are political are wrong. They just don't want to know the truth. But we want to give time and God to tell us who we are really. But honestly, we are not political. We are people from NRM, we are people from UPC, we are people who don't belong to any political party. We have different political parties in TELWA. And I can assure you, the media and anybody listening to me right now, I don't want you to have a reservation in supporting the activities of TELWA. I don't want you to have a reservation in seeing to it that you participate in the activities of TELWA. We are merely here as young people looking for how to help those who cannot speak up. Right now we are talking about help. We have a brother called Waswa Ismail. He's a footballer. He has played for Alliance High School. He's been playing for Garage. As we speak right now, he has a tumor in the brain. They need over 15 million shillings. We don't have anyone else whom we are going to turn to. We are turning to you, to myself. So it is about that we are together. If we can only make everybody able to fend for himself, then honestly, we would have achieved ourselves. So about the perception, you are not wrong to think the way you think, but I would invite you to give us a chance to disapprove your perception, because it is out of that you'll be able to support us. I thank you all.
I want to say, I'm called Manga Moses Kitio, senior superintendent of police. I've worked for some time. I think I've worked for the last 6 years. I'm about to retire. You pray for me. So, you know why I'm saying that me, I have not voted, because I'm talking to the community. For us, anybody, as long as it belongs to the community, is part and partial of fighting crime. Whether I'm meeting group, whether I'm meeting FDC, whether I'm meeting NRM, but I have to, so long as it belongs to that community, I have no problem meeting with it. However, as I say, I've had to testify, TELWA has its aims and objectives. And I pray that the TELWA, the chairmanship and the executive, speaks to that principle of aims and objectives of TELWA. Let it not be divided.
Yes.
Because why these people have come here? Because they are following you somewhere where you are promising them. I'm saying it once and again. I mean, I normally say it because time and again we have seen people doing certain things. I was in Luero some time back. There was a church giving food to people. And we all, they prayed for us there seriously. We could attend. Big, big security people. But in the end, it became quiet. And the people lost their money. And you know, the old people got feeding some small money. At the end of the day, they ran away. This is like came from Shelly. There was a couple who came and they opened up a shop. They were promising to lend motorcycles to load motorcycles to border community. At the end of the day, they fleeced the people and they ran away. But I'm sure TELWA will not do that. Because
I've never seen anything like that before. So you set a record and growing up for us. You know, young people are never together. You never get people sit together, discuss an issue, and take a step forward to do it. So you are setting a record, and we pray that you be role models to other young people out there. Thank you very much. And also for always calling upon other young people to join you. That is special. So TELWA, we pray that God blesses each and every one of you, and we pray that the association grows more and more. And my family and I would like to join TELWA and be part of the family. On behalf of Ms. Surizin Teso, I would like to just put out one announcement that we are calling upon young girls and boys this time to take part in Ms. and Mr. Surizin Teso. This time round, we have the boys take part because tourism is inclusive of everyone. It's not only about the girls. We have to teach the boys also about what it means to come from Teso. Miss Tourism Teso encompasses the Iteso and the Kumam. So if you're a Kumam, we are all Iteso. And you're all welcome to take part in Miss Tourism Teso.
You can't stop, you want to scream. Okay, so we're going to spell TELWA. T E L W A.